here at Ferguson Showroom, and because it is the new year, a lot of people trying to eat healthy, stick with their New Year's resolution. So we're here to help you today. We're with the folks from HMSA. We've got Mawani Wright Van Elst and Danielle Douglas. Hello, thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having us.
Let's talk about that. Everybody, you know, January 1st, a lot of people, including myself, they want to start the new year off right, trying to eat healthier. What are your thoughts on that?
You know, New Year's, it's a fad, right? New Year's, new you. And so everyone tries to go with the newest fad diet. They do an extreme exercise program. They just do something to an extreme. And what we always see is that past January 30th, it's not sustainable. If you even make it to January 30th.
When you do extreme stuff like that, normally you're right. I mean, sadly, people don't stick with it.
Right. And so what we want to do is help you be sustainable all year long. And it's not about, you know, going on the 10-day cleanse or training for a triathlon if you've never run a day in your life. It's about making small changes daily. So we have a blog called Wellbeing Hawaii. It's at wellbeinghi.com. And we've got a lot of great recipes, two of which we're going to talk through today, exercise tips, just small things you can do to just change your daily routine so that you can actually be sustainable, you know, hit your goals, lose weight, whatever your goals are throughout the year.
Okay, and you know what? That's so much more easier to swallow, right? If you just take little steps.
Absolutely.
Change little things day
Absolutely.
By day. All right, so what are the two things we're making today?
So the two things we're going to first make a clean mayonnaise. We go out, we buy mayonnaise, it's, you know, processed, it's got chemicals in it, but you can actually make it at home in less than 5 minutes for half the cost. So we're going to make a clean mayonnaise that you can use in anything, you know, your sandwiches. And we're also going to make cauliflower rice.
I've never heard of that.
It's quite delicious, and it replaces your carb-filled rice.
So I like it.
Yeah.
All right, Danielle, so you are making the mayo today. What's the first step?
Okay, so it just takes a few basic ingredients. You just need an egg. You need some extra light-tasting olive oil. This is different than the extra virgin. It's a little bit, it has more subtle taste, so it doesn't overwhelm the mayonnaise.
So it's called extra light?
Extra light-tasting.
Light-tasting.
So there's an example right here. And then we have, it's up to you, but lemon and lime to season, and then some salt and pepper. I actually like to put lemon and lime, both of them in. So the first step is to take the egg and place it on the counter and let it come to room temperature. So that takes about 2 to 3 minutes. Okay. Just so it's not like super cold out of the fridge. So the first step I'm going to do is crack it in a mason jar.
Have you ever cracked an egg on TV?
No, this is the first time.
So a little bit of pressure with
I'm glad that it went into the mason jar, not on the counter.
Because I know with me, when I have an audience, without fail, the shell will go in there.
Oh, absolutely. No, it's so silent. And then I use this really handy stick blender. Okay. And it makes it really easy to go into the mason jar and stir it up. You need to measure 1 cup of the olive oil. So the trick to making the mayonnaise, too, is to add it in portions. So I do 1/4 cup at a time. So I'll start, and I just kind of eyeball it. And that's about 1/4 cup. Mm-hmm. And then I turn my stick blender on low.
Low so we don't have any mishaps as well.
I might do it high at home.
I've never used a stick blender before.
Yeah,
that's nice.
Great tool. And then you'll notice at first it's still kind of watery. So as you continue to add it, it will thicken. So add another 1/4 cup.
So you're using all of the oil, but you just add it in slowly?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's starting to thicken a little bit more.
All right. We are going to continue with our mayo making. I have never even thought of making my own mayo at home. I think this is brilliant. And this is so interesting how it looks and how it's thick. Like now it's starting to look more like mayo.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And mayonnaise is a base for everything, right? You can, the great thing is at the end of this, you've got either just plain mayonnaise for your sandwich. Danny oftentimes adds like thyme or dill, and so you can use it for like on your salmon.
Make sauces.
I mean, an aioli is a fancy word for saying mayonnaise mixed with something, basically, right? So now you've got a clean, healthy mayonnaise at the end of this that you can use.
So, and the last step is just squeezing the citrus in.
Okay, we're going to save that for our next segment, and then we'll also see some of the things you made with the mayo. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.